Welcome everyone, this video is a student research project of digital culture and society. Our research question is, how do functions of STEAM community influence virtual world participation? As one of the biggest video game distribution platforms, STEAM has an inbuilt community, enabling players to interact with each other outside their in-game experiences. The community is constructed by two major functions: market and workshop. To avoid possible biases, we choose two different game types as our field sites, FPS and simulator. Our research methods focus on participant observation and autoethnography, with online interview as complement. The object of our research covers all kinds of game players of these three game types, including ourselves, with no restriction on whether they use Steam community or not, because we aim to have a comparative analysis to review the impacts of Steam community functions. Our research is connected to the themes of virtual world, mediation, and embodiment. This study starts from April the 5th and ends on April the 20th. Welcome to the first part of our research, which is about the impact of market function in Steam community to the participation in the virtual world of FPS games, brought to you by our researcher Shengyang. His field site is Counter-Strike Global Offensive. A summative sheet of participant observation and autoethnography is constructed based on his field notes during the research period, showing different dimensions of the virtual world and his personal feelings. In the first stage of the research, the Steam community is not involved yet. Shengyang is getting to know some basic settings of the virtual world. He defines the virtual world as a relatively limited virtual space with a set of rules and regulations to play, with a series of classic setup of first-person shooter menus. Other basic information is also introduced, like his playing alone on his personal computer and also some details of the virtual world. Shengyang is under stress for not playing well, while he experiences a high level of immersion with a well-built avatar as his agency and realistic sound effects and visual simulation. In next stage, Shengyang starts to explore the market function of Steam community. He breaks down the virtual space of Steam market detailedly into many components, like the list of virtual goods, search bar, personal account information, and so on. Besides the dimensions of Steam content to the last stage, Shengyang also asks to purchase some goods from the Steam market. The goods are for CSGO, but in this stage he is not using the goods in the game world, so his feelings are simply relevant to the market function. Not many feelings arise from Shengyang for this relatively ordinary virtual space, with only visual feedbacks, as he describes the visual design as being monotone. However, the constantly updating dueling information makes him feel the dynamic of the market like real-world ones, and also feel more involved into this trading process. In the last stage, the usage of Steam market and game experience are put together, applying goods purchased in the market. Many aspects of the virtual world are changed for the participation of Shengyang. For example, now he is able to spray some images on the wall in the game scenes, and the sphere is bought from the market. Moreover, his avatar could also be changed in different ways. The purchasing as an action makes Shengyang feel more involved into the game, while other bodily feelings are not improved, because the changes brought by the goods of the market make the virtual world less realistic for Shengyang visually. He feels less immersed into the world, though the game experience is more entertaining. Audibly, some new pieces of background music from the purchased music box also break the tense atmosphere expected by Shengyang. Now Timothy Ni, which is myself, will introduce the second part of research to you, studying the impact of Steam Workshop to the participation of simulator games. My field study is Euro Truck Simulator 2. My field notes are in the same format to Alex. which makes our research process more standardized. In my early stage of the research, I also played the game without using community function to have a basic understanding of the game virtual world. The virtual space of Euro Truck Simulator 2 basically has two things, tourists and an open world, but the scale of the open world is really large, because the avatar is a truck driver and should run some long distance freight business. The virtual world is realistic, which is a typical art style of simulator games. For my emotion and bodily feelings, when I play for the first time, I feel upset for sure. It's not easy to get used to driving a truck, but when I get familiar with this, I'm impressed by the diversity of visualization of driving a truck on European roads this game brings me, because this game provides players with different perspectives and panels while playing. The sound effects are also delicate. For example, when it rains, the game manages to simulate the sound when many raindrop patters upon the glass of the windshield. Thus, I'm immersed so deeply into the virtual world with immersive bodily feelings. Once the truck crashes and gets a rollover, and I feel like my body balance is also broken at that moment. In the next stage, I explore the workshop function of Steam community independently. I firstly get to know that the Steam workshop is constructed by many different game sectors, then I do the further investigation in the sector of Euro Truck Simulator 2 in order to prepare for the research in the third stage. In this sector, game modules are classified by their types for players to subscribe. Once a player subscribes a module, the module will be automatically installed into the game for players to apply. The modules are from unofficial developers, and they could update their modules. While being in the virtual space of workshop, I mainly feel surprised for the creativity of the developers and expect to try some modules in the game. Visually, the basic design of the workshop is not special and is consistent with the basic color scheme of Steam, but the preview pictures of the modules are colorful and attractive. Though the workshop as a virtual space itself does not have any audio, it provides participants many audio modules to play with. In conclusion, the workshop function of Steam community allows non-official people to work as game developers, which means they could shape the world in terms of its underlying framework. As developers, these participants are no longer simply players, and their non-official background enables the game modules developed to break the regulations and become out of the ordinary. I feel surprised, shocked, and curious for this innovative system of Steam Workshop. Fortunately, my curiosity is fulfilled in the third stage, where I practically apply the modules to the game. The virtual space is tremendously modified for many aspects, especially the look of the truck inside and out. Visually, the diversity of the virtual world is enriched by the new modules, and thus the game simulates the complicated real world even better. For example, the operation panel of the truck could be modified, just like different models of trucks in the real world. Audibly, the open world is also changed, or I would say refined, by the sound effects provided by some modules. For example, a module from the workshop offers players a 3D surrounding audio experience of the train passing by. All this seems making the virtual world more realistic and thus more immersive for me. But what the workshop brings us is more than that. While browsing the workshop, I find an organization named the Pride developed some modules to show their support for LGBTIQ groups. They developed some trailer paint jobs of rainbow flag for players to use, and thus broadcast their ideas. Using these modules actually gives me a sense of detachment from the virtual world for bodily feelings, because they remind me of the real-world social issues. To analytically conclude our research, firstly, I want to cite from Dr. Borsdorf for his definition to a digital virtual environment. Separated online spatial room with virtual characteristics evolved from simplified binary nature of coding. Following this definition, our research is actually about two virtual spaces, Steam community and in-game world. And we try to review the impact of one to the other. So we attempt to figure out the characteristics of these two virtual spaces one by one and put them together to find the impact. In this process, we consider mediation and embodiment. In Rowlett's Handbook of Science, Technology and Society, Daniel and Kelly say that contemporary society maintains a conceptual boundary between the online and the offline that artificially separates and devalues digitally mediated experience. To reverse this devalue, goods from the Steam market, modules from the Steam workshop, utilize several approaches to blur the boundary and establish a more persuasive, immersive mediated experience. When the level of immersion increases, the bodily feelings of the real world are more replaced by the mediated feelings of the virtual world, and the organic flesh is extended through digital processes. The main impact follows this principle, but detailed expressions could alternate for different community functions or different game types. Additionally, in Handbook, Daniel and Kelly also indicates the complex social problems behind agents. This explains why some Steam community contents could be outliers of this impact we summed up here. The reflection of real-world society always exists in virtual spaces, and for games, it draws people back to the reality and lowers their immersion level, consequently.